I like peanut butter. I like peanut butter. Peanut butter. I like peanut butter. Hey everybody, back out the old motorhome. I'm gonna start kind of doing some of the. Well, it really needs to be freshened up a little bit, like on the outside. So one of the things I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go ahead and take off the headlight cover, which is this sort of powdery. Vinylized plastic. I'm gonna sand it down and I'm gonna paint it to kind of give it a new lease on life, because it's gonna be small things like this that actually make this motorhome look pretty good when we're done with it. So this one's gonna be real easy. I mean, if you've got one, it may be different. I've just got four plastic screws. I mean, I have four screws going into the plastic. I'll pull it, I'll clean it real good, I'll rough it up a little bit so it holds paint, and then paint it. So it should be good. There you go. I pulled one off, kind of give you an idea what it looks like. So, time for paint. Okay, so I washed them down real good. Scrubbed them with some soap and water. And what I do is I wipe it down with some naphtha. It's a fast drying thinner. And it'll actually pull off like oils from your fingers and bugs and stuff like that. And it is plastic, so it'll kind of etch it a little bit, which is good, because I'm going to put some carbon fiber look paint on it. Spray it up, should look pretty good. Yes. Here we go, here's the paint. Rust-oleum high performance wheel. This is ideal for metal and plastic. Any angle spray, comfort tip. I do like that kind of silver color. It's gonna make these look kind of silver. Should look pretty good. Okay, so here's the first coat. Whenever you use a paint like this, or actually most any spray paint, you never try to cover everything in one coat. It's always the small coats, especially when you're painting plastic. Small coats is what builds up to give you a good even finish and actually makes the finish stay, so it doesn't just wash or flake off after a while. So this is the first coat. This stuff has a fast recoat time. You can recoat in, I think, about 2 or 3 minutes, depending on the temperature. And it's pretty cool today, so I'm going to give it about 5 minutes in between coats and do, I think, 3 good coats. That'll do it. So it is slightly darker. It was black before. Now it's got kind of a sort of a dark carbon fiber silver look to it, so it should look pretty good. There you go. There's 3 good coats. The texture of the plastic, which is what these light headlight housings are made out of, when you put the paint on, it kind of amplifies a little bit, so it gives it a little bit more texture, which is, that's okay, because that's really kind of what I wanted. Kind of give it that sort of rough feel, you know, because the motorhome's from the 80s, and kind of want to give it its own little look. So I like the fact that the texture has been amplified and look. Yeah, it looks almost like it's hammered. Which is one of my favorite paints. So when this dries completely and hardens up, all that will kind of shrink down, tighten up a little bit, so it won't be nearly as pronounced as it is right now. But overall, I like the color. It's not black and it's not like a light silver. It's kind of right in between. It's a wheel color paint, which is kind of what I was going for, because I want just a little bit of detail to kind of break up the front, because the front's all black, and this will kind of help pretty good. Very nice. I think in my next video, I'm going to go and take the aluminum grill, clean it up, shine it up a little bit, and put some clear coat on it. I'll show you that. Bye-bye. I like peanut butter. I like peanut butter. I like peanut butter. Peanut butter.